Now I'm going to take some time to show you how to use variables and constants in a playground. I've gone ahead and opened this empty playground, and we'll get started by declaring some variables. We know to create a variable that we need to use something like the following syntax. We have the keyword var, then some name for the variable, and its value. For example, I'll create this variable called myJerseyNumber with the value of 5. This creates or declares a variable with the name myJerseyNumber, and when we write this code, Swift works behind the scenes and infers that myJerseyNumber's type is an integer, because 5 is an integer. And we can check this if we hold down the Option key and go up to the variable name and we click it. We can see that it's been declared as an int value. When Swift automatically infers the type of the variable, in this case to int, we call this inferred typing. So let's do another example. So we'll create this variable called myCoolVariable and give it a value of A in double quotes. So if you've created a variable like this before where you use the double quotes, you may already know what Swift may infer this to be, but we can check. And it looks like Swift has interpreted this as a string variable. So myCoolVariable contains a string, and that makes sense. That's what these double quotes mean. That means a string. But this string is just one character. What if we wanted the variable to be of character type because it represents a single character instead of a string type which can represent multiple characters? Is there a way that we can help Swift do this? Actually, there is, and here's how. We'll modify our variable declaration and add a colon after the name and then specify the type that we want. So this is a slightly different syntax than we saw before, but it removes the need for Swift to guess the variable's type because we're explicitly stating it. In this case, we want it to be a character. And when we take the guesswork out of typing for Swift, we call this explicit typing. And if I use the Option click, we can see that this is now a character and no longer a string. In general, Swift does a great job at inferring the types of our variables, so explicit typing is usually not necessary. However, in some cases like this one, you'll want to use explicit typing so that the compiler knows exactly what type you intend for the variable.